Welcome to the channel, my name's Shane. In this video, we're checking out the Rode NT1 5th generation condenser microphone. The Rode NT1 5th gen might look like another standard microphone, but it has a few new tricks and abilities hidden within its classic design. Now, I'm a big fan of the 2014 NT1 microphone, so it'll be interesting to hear how they both compare a little bit later in this video. Before we get going, a huge thank you to Rode for sending this microphone out to the channel for the review. I really appreciate it. You can check it out using my links in the description box below. Let's get into it. Let's talk about some of the features built into the NT1. This is both an XLR and USB microphone, allowing it to be integrated into a Rodecaster Pro setup, an audio interface setup, or directly into any computer using USB-C. One of the massive benefits to the Rode NT1 5th Gen is that it can capture and record audio using 32-bit float. Recording with 32-bit float is a very impressive technology, and paired with this NT1 makes the microphone unclippable. This recording method can kind of be compared to recording RAW in most professional cameras. 32-bit float captures the entire signal of the microphone capsule. This means you can boost quiet recordings without raising the noise floor and reduce clipped audio without losing information. Here's an example of me talking very quietly into the microphone, and then you'll hear it after normalizing the audio in post to minus 1 dB. Here's an example of me talking very quietly into the microphone, and then you'll hear it after normalizing the audio in post to minus 1 dB. And now I'm clipping the audio signal intentionally. This would be unusable on most microphones. I'll normalize this to minus 1 dB. As you can hear, this works awesome and it lets you recover audio that would otherwise be unusable. Usually when you record a quiet pass, raising the gain increases the noise floor, but not with 32-bit float. This is what makes it very impressive. Improving the audio quality even further, we can now record at 192 kHz, allowing for a much more detailed recording thanks to the new analog to digital conversion. The NT1 is loaded with onboard DSP effects with Rode's Effects audio processing. This is the same type of processing found in the Rodecaster Pro, which is dedicated hardware. You can add effects including compression, a high pass filter, noise gate, and Rode's Effects oral exciter, and big bottoms, which give you the big podcasting sound that people love. The Rode NT1 5th generation can be used for most types of recording, including voiceover, podcasting, live streaming, and all types of band and studio recordings. This allows you to connect up to 8 USB microphones to a single computer at the same time and record a podcast, for example. Rode pioneered this software and hardware integration to allow a recording option that wasn't available prior with conventional USB microphones. Let's talk about the specifications and what this means in a practical sense. The Rode NT1 is a condenser microphone. This means if you're plugging it into a Rodecaster or audio interface, you'll need to have phantom power turned on. Now, if you plan on using this microphone over USB-C, you won't have to worry about it as the mic is powered by the port on the computer. This new microphone is loaded with a 1-inch capsule, and it's also a side address microphone, so you'll need to talk only into one side to get the best results. The gold dot denotes the front side of the microphone. Once you find that, you're good to go. The cardioid polar pattern means if I move away from the front of the microphone, the audio will start to fall off. While this microphone doesn't have the same off-axis rejection as a podcasting or dynamic microphone, it's great to have some form of isolation. My room here is a converted bedroom. It's not sound treated or dampened, with the exception of some of the curtains back here. This is the sort of audio quality you can expect from the microphone without any of the fancy effects. The frequency response is listed at 20 Hz to 20 kHz, allowing for a full frequency range capture. This is the entirety of human hearing. With a sound pressure level rated at 142 dB, man, that's super loud. I play in a band, I don't get up to 142 dB. You can put this in front of anything like a brass section, drums, electric guitar, whatever the case may be, and you'll be in business. With a low self noise of only 4 dBA, your audio will stay clean and the microphone itself won't be adding any extra noise into your recordings. Rode has an impressive amount of microphones with low self noise, which is one of the reasons I've purchased so many of them in the past. Let's talk about what we get in the box. Included in the pack, we get everything we need to get going, including a long SC28 USB-C cable, a Rode XLR6 XLR microphone cable, the SM6 shock mount and pop filter combination that I've been using throughout this video. Rode were also nice enough to send me one of their Rode beanies, so if you see me doing a camera review in the park over winter, I'll be putting that on. The SM6 shock mount is also completely compatible with the PSA-1 boom arm from Rode, which is awesome. I've had no problems getting this mic stand into position using this setup, and it hasn't moved whatsoever. Let's check out the proximity effect. The proximity effect makes the microphone sound bigger and rounder sounding the closer you get to it. One of my favorite things about my original NT1 is its excellent proximity effect, and this one also sounds great. Let's check out the off-axis rejection using this old school HP mechanical keyboard. So I'm just gonna type and talk at the same time, and then I'll stop talking. How much of that comes through on the audio? Odds are you're still hearing some of it. Now, if I turn on the processing, which enables a noise gate, have a listen to the difference. I can't hear any of that getting through on my headphones. It's not to say it isn't, but as of right now, it sounds completely different. So yeah, this noise gate functions beautifully. While this microphone sounds great, it doesn't have the best off-axis rejection, unless of course you're using the processing, which enables that noise gate, and you can get rid of a lot of background noise. I highly recommend using that in any type of situation where you might be typing or doing anything on the desk, because this microphone is prone to picking up a lot of audio. Large diaphragm condenser microphones can be prone to excessive plosives, and the NT1 fifth generation is no exception. For those with great mic technique, like Mike Delgadio, great channel, go subscribe to him as well, this won't be an issue as you can talk past the diaphragm rather than directly into it. But for everyone else like me, use a pop filter, it will make a huge difference. Let's take a look. Peter promptly picks potatoes and potassium. Peter promptly picks potatoes and potassium. Peter promptly picks potatoes and potassium. As you can hear, keep the pop filter on. Over to the audio comparisons, starting with the Rode NT1 versus the Rode Broadcaster. I want to throw this in because if you're thinking about buying this microphone, it may be worth getting the Broadcaster, even though it is more expensive, if you just want to do podcasting and you've already got an XLR solution. I want to throw this in because this might sway you one way or the other. Both of these microphones sound great in my headphones right now. Although I don't have a pop filter on the Broadcaster, I'm just going to talk across it and it should help me with those plosives. The benefit of this type of microphone is it's an end address mic and it also has better off-axis rejection. Whereas the NT1, as we've seen, doesn't have the best off-axis rejection, but it's great in every other situation. And now we're listening to the difference between the new NT1 and one of the original NT1s. This isn't the first gen. I think this might be the last one prior to that, but I've got one from about 10 years ago. It's my favorite vocal recording microphone of all time, but I can't hear a difference between both of these in my headphones. Let us know if you can hear a difference in the comment section. Let's wrap this video up. I'm gonna give you my thoughts about the Rode NT1 fifth generation. Again, this is an extremely flexible microphone. If you're looking for a one and done mic, this would do a really great job, except for in one scenario, if you have a lot of ambient noise. Now, while I'm not in a treated room whatsoever, apart from my little curtains back here, this microphone will pick up a lot more of what's going on anywhere around it when you compare it up against a dedicated podcasting microphone. Now, this Broadcaster is still my favorite for podcasting, but for vocal applications outside of that, the NT1 sounds fantastic. But just know these microphones, as easy as they are to drive, you don't need a lot of gain once you turn phantom power on. The downside is they do pick up a lot of noise, a lot of keyboard noise, and so forth. Again, I'm thankful that Rode provides software that can enable a noise gate, because this will drastically help your overall situation. But overall, this is a fantastic microphone. I can highly recommend it. Again, a massive thank you to Rode for sending this out. If you have any comments or questions, leave them below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Leave a thumbs up, check the links below, and I'll catch you soon. See ya.